When you think of leaving the Earth, you probably think of something that looks like this. This is the Saturn V launching Apollo 11 to the moon. It was a chemical rocket burning a mixture of kerosene and liquid oxygen to get its payload, the Apollo astronauts, off the Earth. Chemical rockets are basically an exercise in brute force, but they're not the best way to go. They use a ton of resources and are bad for the environment and can kill people. What if there was a better, easier, cheaper, less environmentally disastrous way of leaving the planet? One company, Zero to Infinity, is working on a different method today using Rockoons. Rockoons are a hybrid of a rocket and balloon that split the process of reaching orbit into two parts. First, the balloon rises into the upper atmosphere, then the rocket adds the needed momentum to launch something into orbit or to another planet. In March of 2017, Zero to Infinity launched a balloon to about 82,000 feet. At that point, they were above 99% of the atmosphere, so they ignited a small rocket motor. Another company, Acra, was using a Rockoon-type launch system for its entry into the Google Lunar XPRIZE competition. But if using a balloon to lift a rocket seems like old technology, that's because it is. The concept originated in March of 1949 for better high-altitude atmospheric science. Rockoons are actually a simple and ingenious approach to spaceflight. Instead of fighting against gravity, they turn gravity into an advantage. A sounding rocket is suspended beneath a large balloon made of super thin plastic, usually polyethylene, that is filled with a small amount of helium. As the balloon rises, the atmospheric pressure gets lower and the helium heats with sunlight, allowing it to expand and fill the volume of the balloon. The balloon can then ascend to a point where it's above most of the atmosphere, meaning the rocket suspended beneath it is in a near vacuum. It's at this point that the rocket fires, and because there's almost no atmosphere, the rocket is much more efficient. Another benefit of Rockoons is that they can accommodate all kinds of payloads. Satellites on rockets need to be folded and housed in fairings, basically an aerodynamic case, to keep them safe from launch vibrations and fit them on top of a rocket. With a Rockoon, because the rise to launch altitude is slow and smooth, the air doesn't tear apart the thing you're launching. This means the payload can be less aerodynamically sound and still fly safely. It's just protected by a lightweight fairing. Perhaps the most famous use of Rockoons was a series of launches done by James Van Allen in August and September of 1952. He was able to send instruments 50 miles up to test radiation near the Earth's poles. It was through these launches that Van Allen discovered there was significant radiation at high altitudes. Follow-up observations with the Explorer 1 satellite in 1958 allowed Van Allen to discover the radiation belts that bear his name. Of course, mentioning the Van Allen belts usually gets people pointing to them and crying foul, saying, "We can't go through them to get to the moon, so we never went to the moon." Well, astronauts did. I've got a video going into those details on my own channel, Vintage Space. And speaking of the moon and other planets, should Pluto be a planet again? We talk about how it could be in this video. What's your favorite non-traditional way to get into space? Let us know in the comments, give us a like, and subscribe so you never miss an episode.